All right, so here's the general setup that explains what we're doing here. So we're going to look not at this particular equation, but at a more general equation, which is just like it. X squared plus bx equals c. So there's more letters now. There's the letter x, which represents our mystery unknown number. And now there's letters b and c, which are not representing mystery numbers anymore. They're representing constant given numbers. It's just that we're not specific about which ones they are. So here and here, b was 10 and c was 39, but we want to explain the algorithm in a way that doesn't depend on which particular numbers we're using. So we use b and c. Okay, but these b and c letters are playing a different role from x. We imagine that b and c are known to us and we have to solve for x. So what do? Well, we mimic what we did up here. We add b over 2 squared to both sides. That's the little square that we're adding there. And now what's on the left-hand side is a perfect square, just like this here is a perfect square. It is equal to x plus b over 2 all squared. Now let's check that. If we square this, we get x squared plus 2 times the product. 2 times x times b over 2, that's exactly bx. And b over 2 squared, well, there it is right there. And this thing here, we can just write it as c plus b squared over 4. Now, in this form, it's much like this equation is here. We take x plus b over 2 squared equals this, so x plus b over 2 will be the square root of this, where we're introducing a new terminology, the idea of a square root, a number whose square is this. So we end up getting x equals the square root of c plus b squared over 4 minus b over 2, because the b over 2 comes around to the other side. So we're introducing this surd notation for the square root. That was an innovation also due to the Arabs. So, for example, the square root of 16 is 4, the square root of 25 is 5, and so on. All right, let's have a look at this example, which mimics exactly what we were doing here, but rewritten in a more modern form that's familiar to all students of algebra. So here's the modern way of rewriting what Al-Khwarizmi did in that previous example. Usually today, we think about a quadratic equation in this form. Ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0, where a, b, and c are three specific given numbers, and x is an unknown number that we're trying to find. And we'll assume that this coefficient a is non-zero, so we really have a quadratic equation. And now there's a step-by-step procedure to transform this equation into an equation for x. And this is a well-known formula that all students learn. And how to get that solution is almost as important, perhaps maybe it's more important, than actually the solution itself. Okay. So it's something that all serious students of mathematics should know, what the various steps are to go from here to here. So what do? First thing is we take the a and we take it as a factor. So a times x squared plus b over a times x, and we bring the c to the other side, giving us minus c there. We divide by a, so this a comes over the other side, is minus c over a. And what's inside here now, we complete the square in exactly the same way as we did on the previous slide. We do that by adding the square of half of this coefficient, b over 2a. So we add the square of that to both sides so that it's still a valid equation. That makes what's on the left-hand side here a perfect square, x plus b over 2a all squared. And when we simplify what's on the right, the common denominator is 4a squared, and there will be a b squared from here. And when we take this over a common denominator of 4a squared, we have to multiply the top by 4a, giving us b squared minus 4ac on the numerator here. So this squared equals this quantity, so what's inside is the square root of the right-hand side. So we put the square root of the numerator and square root of the denominator, well, that will be 2a. And because the square root has an ambiguity in terms of sign, if we have one solution, then negative it is also a solution, we put a plus or minus here, telling us that we can either take plus this or minus this. The square root is, by convention, always a positive number. So when we talk about the square root of 9, we always mean 3, not minus 3. And then to go from here to here, it's simply a question of taking this b over 2a and bringing it to the other side. So finally, x equals minus b plus or minus square root b squared minus 4ac all over 2a, a well-known formula for all students. And in our context, we can actually use this as long as this condition is satisfied, that what's inside here, this b squared minus 4ac term, had better be a square, because we want to take the square root of it. So in particular, it's got to be positive. It's got to be positive, and it's got to be a square. Because right now, we're still working in the realm entirely of rational numbers. Okay, so that's good. That's the classic formula for the quadratic equation. Next time, we're going to talk about an important ingredient to this business, which is how do you actually find a square root? We've been assuming that you can kind of do it, but how do you actually find the square root of a number? That's a very interesting algorithm, which we'll discuss next time. I hope you'll join me for that. I'm Norman Wildberger. Thanks for listening.